फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज द सॉर्टिंग द डेटा. सॉर्टिंग मीन्स द डेटा शुड बी सॉर्टेड इधर इन असेंडिंग ऑर्डर और इन ए डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. सॉर्टिंग बाय डिफॉल्ट सॉर्टिंग कैन बी डन इन टू वेज असेंडिंग ऑर्डर आर इन डिसेंडिंग असेंडिंग ऑर्डर आर डिसेंडिंग. बाय डिफॉल्ट इन आर सॉर्ट्स द डेटा data in ascending order. By default in R sorts the data in ascending order. Here we would like to check the syntax. How do we write the syntax? Does sort happens at the observation level or a variable level? Sorting always happens the observation level, but it is going to use the variable names. Sorting will always happens at observation level, but it is going to use all the it is going to use all the variables it is going to use the variable levels. Basically all the variable means whatever the variable you want to use to sort the data, that variable you are going to use. Okay, let me write down the syntax for everyone easily understanding purpose. Let me write the syntax for the sorting the data in R.
What mean by observation level? I couldn't understand.
Observation means whenever you sorted that data, observation position will change from first position. Let's say first position to third position will come. Third position will come into the first position. Or 100th position may come into the first position when you sort that data. For example, you have a length is a one variable. Let's say minimum value of length, you know, 125th record. When we sort that data in ascending order, ascending means increasing order from low to high. Whatever the position in the minimum value, which is in the 125th position, will come into the first position. That is the meaning at observation level. So the ultimate goal is observation position will change. That is the meaning of observation level. Is it clear? Okay. Now
means once it is ascending ordered, it was means the row will be changed, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. It is using the all the variables. How do we write the syntax? How do we write the syntax? Let me easily tell you that. Let's say your data set is ABC. So you are storing into the ABC one. Okay, you are storing the data into ABC1. You want to sort the data. ABC is your existing data. ABC data, you want to sort the data and it is going to be stored into the ABC1. Here before comma is the rows, after comma is the columns. Let's say before comma is the rows, after comma is the column. So now sorting will happen at the row position or column position? Sorting will happen at the row position. It doesn't happen the column position. As we mentioned that if we sort the data, row positions will change. So that means sorting will happen at the row position. So do I need to write at the row position or column position? Row position. How do you write? Order of your variable name, whatever, for example ABC dollar X, that is the meaning. Simple, done. For example, ABC1, let me write down again, ABC of order means ordering the data. ABC is the data set. From that particular variable you need to do. So the variable name is the, to access that variable you are using the dollar symbol x comma close. This is the simple syntax. So here comma after comma means space, that means it will consider the all the column names. Yes, default ascending order. I'm coming there. Suppose I want to sort the data two variables, based on the two variables, more than one variable at a time. In the reality, it doesn't exist. Sometimes in entry point of also, they might ask you, let's say, how do you sort the data two variables? How do you sort the two variables, x1, x2 are two variables. How do we sort the x1, x2 in ascending order? For that case, how do we go? ABC 1, ABC, order, we have a ABC, dollar, X, comma, ABC, dollar, Y, comma. First it will sort the data X and then after it will sort the data in Y. No, there is no cap symbol. Maybe when you're writing somewhere it happened. ABC is the existing data order, ordering the data. ABC of dollar X, that means from the ABC data set, dollar means accessing. X is a one variable and another same ABC data set. Y is the another variable. Based on that, we sort the data. Okay. Now, here we want to understand. Suppose I want to sort the data in descending order. Suppose we would like to sort the data in descending order. How do we sort the data in descending order? Simple. ABC 1, ABC data set, order, minus symbol. If I keep the minus symbol before that variable, ABC dollar Z. If we keep minus symbol before the variable name, we can consider as sorting the data in descending order. We can consider sorting the data in descending order. In one of the interview point, there was the question like this. If I have three variables, ABC is the data set. In the ABC data set, you have a three variables, X1, X2, X3. X1, you need to sort the data in ascending order. X2, you need to sort the data in descending order. X3, again, you need to sort the data in ascending order. In an interview point of view, in one of the company, there was the question. We have a data set ABC. You have three variables, X1, X2, X3. Here in this case, how do you sort the data? X1 should be sorted in ascending order. X2 should be sorted in descending order. And X3 should be sorted in, again, in ascending order. How do you sort the data in three variables? For that, simple. So I'm going to store in ABC1, ABC, so again order of ABC dollar X1 comma minus ABC dollar X2 comma ABC dollar X3 close. ABC dollar X1, that means we did not specify the minus symbol before the variable. That means it will sort the data in ascending order. So separating the two variables should be separated by comma. Minus ABC dollar X2 means it will sort the data in descending order. Third one is ABC dollar X3. That means ABC is a data set, X3 is a another third variable to sort the data. That is what we are going to do now. That is about the sort. Shall we do a lab for this sorting? Any questions before we are going to the lab? Any questions, guys? Yeah. Let me import the data set. So we imported the data set, auto data set. Here we have a one variable called length variable, right? We want to sort the data length by default. First we sort the data in ascending order. Then we will see how do we sort the data in descending order. Here in this case, first sorting the data in ascending order. That means first we will get the minimum value and last record will get the maximum value. In the length variable, let's first cross validate what is the minimum value of length variable, what is the maximum value of the length variable. How do we do that? Sorts the data. First min of finding the minimum value auto dollar length. Auto dollar length. So what is the minimum value in the auto dollar length? 141 point. Maximum of auto dollar length. Maximum value is 208.1. Now here in this case, we want to understand about the how do we sort the data. Let's create the auto one, auto of order auto dollar length comma. That is the meaning what we have written so far. Yes, first we written the auto is existing data set. Square bracket, we are mentioning everything in the rows, order of auto dollar length. Auto dollar length means in the auto data set we are accessing the length variable. Did we mention the minus symbol before the variable? No. That means what sorts is doing? It is doing ascending order. If we mention the minus symbol before the variable, it will do in the descending order. But we did not mention the minus symbol before the variable. That means it is sorting the ascending order. Auto one, go back. And which variable have done? Length variable. So what is the minimum first value should be there? The first value should be 141.1. See. The first value should be the 141.1. If I go to the last record, what is the last record it should be? 208. See, this is the last record. 205 records, right? This is the last record will be 208.1. Does it sort the perfectly? Yes. Now let's sort the data in descending order. Here let me write down by default R sorts works in R as an ascending order. Descending order. How do we perform descending order? Auto 2 is equal to auto of order minus auto dollar length. Sorry. See, we did not get any error. So auto 2 will be the, what is the first record should be there in auto 2? 208. Is it correct? 208.1. Does it make sense? Yes. Now we have the two variables, length and width. Let's see how do we sort that length and width in ascending order. How do we write the syntax for this? Sorts the data by using two variables. Auto 3 is equal to auto of order auto dollar length comma auto dollar width comma auto order of auto dollar length comma auto dollar width. So automatically auto 3 will sort the two variables. Length and first will be first, and like this it will sorts the data. That is all about the sorting. Now how do, once we sort the data in general, what happens in the real time also when we are doing, once we report, once we receive the data, what we need to do? We need to import the data into the R tool. Assume that as of now we are using the R tool. Once we import the data into the R tool, we need to check the how many, what is the dimensions, what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value, and then after how many number of records we have, how many number of columns we have, and we have the, what are the variable names, is there any missing value. If we require to sort the data, we will sort the data. These kind of things we will do, and then what we need to do, if there is possibility to create the variable, we will create it. Once we do that, we need to sort the data in ascending order or descending order. One second, I think someone is in there. Prasad, can you keep mic in mute? We sort the data in ascending order or descending order. Once we sort the data in ascending order or in descending order, what we need to do? We need to remove the duplicate records. How do we remove the duplicate records? For that, how do we remove the duplicate? How do we remove the duplicate records? We have a one function in R, duplicated. We have a one function in R, duplicated. It will give us the true false cases. We have a one function called duplicate. It will give us the true false. True means there are the duplicated records. False means there are no, those records are the unique records. True means if there are any duplicates, those are called as the true. False means the records which are the unique, those are the unique. Now we need to understand, always removing the duplicates will happen at two levels. One is at the row level, second one is at the primary key level. Removing the duplicates will happen at two levels. One is at row level and second one is at particular ID level. ID means your primary key. For example, I have a one row like this, first row and second row. First row, I do have a ID, age, salary. Here, assume that scenario 1, case 1. ID is 123, age is 24, salary is 10,000. Second row record also 123, 24, 10,000. Third row will be 125, 15 and 50,000. Like this we have. Here first row is exactly the second row. First row is exactly the second row. That means we are removing the duplicates at row level. This is the row level. If entire row is exactly, first row is exactly the same as the second row, or entire row is exactly the same as the another entire row, that is called as the row level duplicates. For example, here I take the one more example, 123, 25. Here one ID is 123, here also ID is 123. But first row and fourth row is not exactly the same. If I look at the ID level, first row and fourth row are the duplicated. But if I look at the row level, first row and fourth row is not a duplicated rows. If we look into the first row and fourth row, those are not the same at row level, but at ID level, first row and fourth row is same. Clear? Now how do we remove the duplicates? Let me unmute. Here let me first install the one data set. The data set is the bill data set. Bill is the telecom bills, like every month you are getting the bills. Here we have the various attributes. We have a total 9462 observations along with 7 variables. Those are customer ID, active account date, and the next one is the customer package ID, billing segment, customer segment, status and bill amount. If first row is exactly the second row, then those two records will be a duplicate record. If first customer ID and second customer ID the same, but remaining columns are not the same, those are the duplicate at customer ID level. Let's do first row level duplication, remove the duplicate, and then we will go at the customer ID level duplicate, right? For example, removing the duplicates, we have a one function dupes is equal to duplicated of bill, duplicated of bill. So here dupes will give us the true or false for the each and every row. Here in this case we want to know how many trues are there, how many false are there. To understand, to get true and false record counts, further what we are going to use, simply summary function, summary of dupes. Summary of the dupes will get us know that 9452 records, which are the, in the summary we will get the two mode. Mode is a logical. Logical means we have only two options, either true or false. In the true cases, true means duplicated rows. In entire bills data, total number of records are 9462. Out of that, how many records which are duplicated? 10 records which are the duplicate. How many records which are unique? 9452 records which are the unique, and remaining 10 records which are the duplicated record. Now I want to create a data set which are only duplicated records. So how many records will come in my new data set? Only 10 records will come into the new data set. Create a data set only for duplicated records. Create a data set only for duplicated records. How do we create that? Bill is equal to, dupe bill is nothing but duplicated bill records, bill of dupes, comma. I will explain the reason why I said the bill of dupes. So how many records we got? 10 records. Here dupe bill is nothing but creating the duplicated bill records as a data set name as dupe underscore bill. So in the dupes, we created the dupes. In the dupes data set, what are the things will be there? In the dupes, we have a two things only, true or false, right? True or false, because it will dupes where you storing from the duplicated data set, duplicate function. We applied the duplicate function to the bill data set. Whatever the results which we got, those results we are stored into dupes. In the dupes, we have the two kind of facilities. What are those? True and false. True is nothing but those records are the duplicated records. False is nothing but those records are the unique records. Okay, perfect. Now what we are going to do, we are want to create the only the duplicate records. Duplicated records is nothing but true records, right? So from where we need to create? From bill data set only we need to get those 10 records. That is the reason we said the bill of dupes. Dupes means only, if I mention the dupes, it will only get the, only get the true records. Now you may get the question, what if we want to get the false records? How do we write? Create false record means unique records. Create unique data set. How do we write? Unique bill is equal to, unique bill is equal to bill of exclamatory mark of dupes. Exclamatory mark of dupe means it will give the false value. How many records you have to get? 9452 record. Exclamatory of dupes means it will give the false record. Without exclamatory marks, it will give the true record itself. Without exclamatory mark, it will give the true records. Here in this case, now we have a one simple function for the row level. We have a one simple function to remove the duplicates without writing using the duplicate function. Other way around to remove the duplicates at row, other way around to remove the duplicates at row level. Here in this case, we have the, for example, bill1 is equal to, unique function is there. Unique function of bill. Then how many records need to get in the bill1? 9452 records. See, bill1 data set which consists of 9452 records. Simple, we are without using the duplicate function, all these things. For row level, we are going to use the bill unique function. Unique function all automatically remove the duplicates at row level. Simply we write unique function will remove the duplicates at row level. Unique function will remove the duplicates at the row level. Any questions, guys? Any questions who are on the call?
No, Koti.
No, thank you.
No.
Thank you. Now, first what we did, now, as of now, this case, we are removing the duplicates at row level, right? Now, we would like to remove the duplicates at particular column level or particular ID level. Okay, how do we remove the duplicates? Here, if you go to the build list, the raw data, in the build data set, we have the customer ID. Let's remove the duplicates at customer ID. First step, what is the first step we need to do? Removing the duplicates at customer ID level. Removing the duplicates at customer ID level. How do we remove? See, here I am taking dupes underscore cust is equal to, we are using the duplicate function. We need to get how many duplicates are in our data set. For that, we are in the duplicate function bill dollar customer ID. Bill dollar means bill is a data set. To access a particular variable, we are going to use the customer ID variable. Bill is a one data set. Dollar symbol means to access a variable. Customer ID is the, we are doing at the customer ID level. So, summary of dupes cust. Summary of the dupes cust means it will tell us, it will give the logical mode, how many trues are there, how many false are there. At row level, how many duplicates we have? Only 10 records, which are the duplicates. Now, in the summary, if you are looking at the customer ID level, how many duplicates we have? 73 duplicates. So that means row level are having the less duplicates, or does the column level are having the less duplicates? row level are having the less duplicate. Make sure that always row level will have the less duplicate as compared with the particular column level, because there is a more probable chances at least one of the record in a particular row might be different with the other records. That could be a reason row level is having the less duplicates as compared with the column level. Now I want to create a data set for only the duplicate records at customer ID level. In my new data set, how many number of records I am going to get? 73 records. We are creating the data set for the duplicate records. We are going to get 73 records. Here in this case, creating the duplicated records data set at ID level. So dupes cust dupe is equal to bill of dupes cust. See, dupe cust dupe is equal to 73 observation. Did we get this? 73 observation. Now we want to create the data set at the unique records. How many number of unique records we are going to get? 9389 records we are going to get. 938, let's say dupe cust unique is equal to bill of exclamatory mark dupes cust comma. So 9389 records we got. Now your assignment for tomorrow.
Hi Kuti.
Hi. Tell me.
How can we do it for character level data? We are doing for numerics.
Here we can do character, keep the character data, that's all.
That's enough.
Same. Bill dollar, whatever the variable, keep it exactly the same.
Okay.
Here in this case, now what we are going to do? Now I am going to provide you the data set after this session. End of the session, I provide you the data set. The data set name is the complaints data set. First step will be you need to sort the data at customer ID level and remove the duplicate. Identify the duplicates. Create a new data set at row level after removing the duplicates. Basically, create a new data set. Create a new data set at ID level, at customer ID level. ID means customer ID level. This is an assignment for you tomorrow. sorts the data at customer ID level, identify the duplicates, how many are the true or how many are the unique records, as well as how many are the duplicate records. Create a new data set at row level, create a new data set at ID level. Here in this case, this is an exam assignment for you all of you. Okay. Okay. And then we are creating the new data set, removing the duplicates. Okay. Now, is it clear, guys? Any questions, guys, who are in the online?
What agree here?
I agree.
Here, in this last script, you have mentioned like dupes underscore cust, comma, close bracket. Use that variable after comma, what will happen?
Where after comma, it will be all the columns we will get it, right? This is the build data set, square bracket. Before comma, it considers the rows. After comma, it considers the column. Once we remove the duplicates, and we need to get all the variables right, that is the meaning.
I'm not getting, sorry.
Here, build data set, we have the square bracket. What does it mean? Before the comma, square bracket means it will consider the rows. After comma, it will consider the columns. So we are removing the duplicates at the row level. So once we remove the duplicates, we need to get the all the column remaining columns. So for that, we are using the comma after that space.
Okay. If we are removing duplicates at row level, we need to give the before that.
Yes. Before comma is the row, right? Before yeah. comma is the rows. After comma, it considers the columns.
Okay, now this one we are removing the duplicates at the column level, right? ID level, right? So
ID means ID is a variable name within, again, based on the rows only. It will, if the two rows in the ID variable, if two rows are, I mean, two records are exactly the same, record means again row only. If two records are exactly the same, then we remove it. But ID as a column, particular column, we are using that, but we are not removing the duplicate at column level. Only particular variable we are using.
Okay.
Yeah. So that also, even if I take a particular column also, it need to works at row level only. It doesn't work at column level. Clear or not clear? Hello?
Clear, Koti.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. Here, next topic is, once we sort the data, what we have done? We have identifying the or removing the duplicates. That is what we have done. For example, I do have two data sets now. Now, so far, how many data sets we are doing? Only one data set. What if we have the two data set? I want to join the two data sets. Before joining, let's find out what do you mean by merge and what do you mean by join. Merge and join are to append the data at horizontal level. Merge and join, append the data at horizontal levels. Merge and join appends the data at horizontal level. Here in this case, now what is the difference between the merge and join? Before we merge the data sets, we need to remove the duplicates at ID level. ID means primary key. If you want to append the two data set, there should be some common key in between the two variables. Based on that common key, we need to remove the data sets. First, merge and join appends the data at horizontal level, because horizontal means like this. First, the main difference between the merge and join, if you want to merge the data, the two data sets, whatever the data sets you are going to merge, the two data sets should not have any duplicated records. And the second point will be, we are removing the duplicates at common key in the both the data set. That is a common variable in the both the data sets. If you want to merge or if you want to join, there should be a same key in both data set. If you want join or merge the data sets, there should be a same common key in both data sets. Generally, we can do merge or join. If you are using join, there is no need to sort the data. There are the four kind of joins are there. There are four kinds of joins. First one will be inner join. Second one will be left join. Third one will be right join. Fourth one will be full join. First one will be the inner join. Second one will be the left join. Third will be the right join. Fourth will be an full join. Now, how do we check what is the left join, what is the right join, all these things? Let me draw a Venn diagram so that you can easily understand about the what do you mean by left join, what do you mean by right inner join and full join, right? Here we have the one X A, here we have a B. We are doing the inner join, that means common portion between the two data sets. The common portion is the, this is the part is the inner join. Now left means all the left side records, left join means all the left side records, left join means all the left side records along with common data. Common data means inner join data basically. Common data means inner join data will be created. All the left side records along with the common data, we will form the left join. All the left side records along with the common data in a join, we will form the left join. Okay. Now, how do we get that? For example, left join data. This is the data A, left B. This portion will get. This is the left join. Clear? Now right join means right join means all the right side records along with common data, we will form the right join. Here in this case, we'll take this and this one, this portion. This is the right this is the meaning of the right join. All the right side records along with the common data, we will form the right join. Okay. Now full join means both the common data set, this entire portion. When you add in the full join, this common portion, it will repeating the twice. We need to do like this. P of A union B means combining the two data set A plus B minus A intersection B. So A plus B means full join means adding the two data set, we need to remove the common portion. The reason is that common portion is repeating the common portion which will be in the A data set as well as the common portion which is in the B data set. So that means it is repeating the twice. Ideally any data set should not repeat the twice. So that is the reason we are removing the common portion. When we are adding the A and B data set, common or intersection portion is repeating twice. As per the rules, none of the data should not repeat twice. So we need to remove the A intersection B portion. Okay, we need to remove the A intersection B portion. Now, how do we perform the joins? By default, R sorts the data inner join. By default, R sorts the data as an inner join. R joins the data as a inner join. Okay, can let me write down the syntax for all this thing. Inner join, the syntax here, merge. ABC is the one data set. Assume that XYZ is the another data set. By is equal to by ID, unique ID, all dot all is equal to false. All is equal to false means all is equal to false means it will, it doesn't give the all the data, it will just give us the common data. You can also write like this, merge ABC XYZ by is equal to unique ID. Unique IDs are common key in the both the data sets. Okay, suppose if you want to do the left join, again merge ABC XYZ by unique ID, all dot x is equal to true. This is the standard syntax, all dot x is equal to true. All dot x means left side part. All dot x is equal to true. That means all dot x means it is giving the left side portion of the data. All dot x is equal to true is nothing but it gives us the left side portion of a data.
Here, what is the meaning of X?
X means by X means first we have a two data sets, right? It will say the X axis, I mean X and Y. X means always it will take the left side one. X is the standard notation they keep to understand about, to system or recognize about the left side part. Y means right side part. It is a just common, every time is it should be the exactly the same, it should not change. That is the standard syntax point.
Okay.
This is the X is the, it indicates about the left side data. If I want to do the right join, how do I do? All dot right join means everything is the same. Now merge ABC comma XYZ by unique ID comma all dot Y is equal to true. Your X and Y should be the small letters, sir, not the capital letters. X and Y should be the small letters. Y indicates right join symbol. X indicates left join symbol. Okay. Y indicates right join, X indicates left join. Suppose we want to do the full join. Suppose we want to do the full join. How do we do the full join? All is equal to true. All is equal to true. So full join means merge ABC XYZ by is equal to unique ID comma all is equal to true. All is equal to true means it indicates about the full join. All is equal to true means indicates the full join. and some cross validation or cross checks while doing the some cross checks for both left join and right join. Left join cross check will be how many number of records which are in left side data that should be the same even after perform the left join operation. How many number of records which are in left side data that should be the same even after perform the left join operation? For example, A is the 500, B is the 300. A data set which consists of 500 records, B is the 300. A is the left side data, B is the right side data. When we are performing the left join, merge, number of records should be 500. It should not be greater than 500 or less than the 500. If it is greater than 500 or less than 500, there is some issue with your join. There is some issue with your join. Same means like example. Yes. Left join. When we do the left join, how many? For example, we are doing the A data set is the left side, B data set is the next.
Both are same. It will be only
left join only. It is the left join only 500. When you are doing the right join, it will get the only 300 records only. Correct. You won't get the 500.
Okay.
That is I'm about next point I will cover that. Let's say you have a data set, A data set, and you have a B data set. In the A data set, you have a 500 records. In the B data set, you have a 300 records. So assume that A left to join B. A left to join B. So we are performing the left to join means how many number of records before performing the left to join. Even after performing the left to join also, number of records should be the same. Before performing the left to join, how many records we have in the left side data? 500 records. Even after performing the left to join, how many number of records we have to get? 500 records. If you are getting more than 500 or less than 500, there is some issue with your join. That means by default you can say that there is some duplicates in the data set. Because of the duplicates, number of records can be more than 500 or less than the 500. That is the reason. For example, A right join B. In this case, right join means before performing the right join, how many number of records which are in the right side of a data, that number of records should be equal to the after perform the right join. Here in the B data set, how many number of records we have? 300. Even after performing the right join also, we need to get how many number of records we have to get? 300 records we have to get. But when we are performing the full join, this is the left join, this is the right join. When you are performing the full join, make sure that A plus B minus common data, A intersection B. A intersection B is nothing but inner join. 500 plus 300 minus common portion of the data. These are the tricks we have to remember while performing the merge or join operations. And clear? Yes. Now, here in this case, how do we perform the operations in join operations in, for example, bill data we have taken. Let's take the complaints data. Let me join. Let me take the data sets which are commercial data. Address data is the one data set which I am taking. In the address data, there is a 1369. We have the slots data. So in the both data set, slots data which is 1764, in the address data we have the 1369. In the both data set we have the common keys unique ID. How do we do that? So joins the data. First, the inner data is equal to merge orders, comma, slots, comma, by is equal to unique ID. So, inner data which consists of how many records we have? 8 records. Inner join data which consists of the 8 records, right? Left data is equal to merge function. What we need to do? Orders, slots, by is equal to unique ID, comma, all dot x is equal to all dot x is equal to true means left join. Now how many records we need to get in our left join data? 1369 records we have to get. In the left data we got exactly the same inner data, left data, because address we have taken the left. Let me take the right data.
One doubt, Koti.
Yes, please. Go ahead.
Here you are given by equal to unique underscore ID. So it would automatically identify the unique ID, or we supposed to give the unique for both the table.
Yeah, it is the unique ID is the first variable, which is the common data, common variable, common key in the both data set. We have to give the name.
Okay.
Before we are joining or perform the merge operation, make sure that common key ID should be the same in both the data sets. Write data is equal to merge orders, comma, slots, data set by again unique id comma all dot y is equal to true. Now how many records we have to get, sir? How many records? Right side data. What is the right side data we have? Slots. How many number of records we have in the slots data? 1764. So at the end of the day, after performing the right join also, how many number of records we have to get? 1764. So right data also, how many records we got exactly? 1764. Yes. Now full join is equal to, full data is equal to merge order comma slots by unique id all is equal to true. Can anyone guess how many number of records in the left data? First, how many records we have? 1369 plus 1764 minus 8. 8, why we have mentioned the minus 8? Those are the 8 records which are the common records or intersection record or inner data. So in our data set, so when we perform the full join, full data, how many number of records we have to get? Error as a data from default, something I have written wrong. Full data merge. Yes, we have mentioned the orders. Orders is the data set. Full data is exactly 3125. That is the meaning of this full data. This is all about joins as well as the sorting, as well as removing the duplicate.